Governor Schwarzenegger's administration and fire officials have been monitoring fires, and right now state fire officials are going to update us on the status of these fires and the response that is taking place. We're going to go live now to Mather Field at the Operation of Emergency Services, where a briefing is now underway.
We are providing information centers at each of those shelters to help identify what some of the shelter needs are. And we are also beginning the process for identifying what transitional housing and temporary housing needs to be made available to those who have lost their homes, lost all their property, and may not have insurance or other means. Obviously, we'll be dealing with them one-on-one at the shelters and at these local assistance centers. So with that, I'd like to turn it over now to Chief John Carney, who's the division chief for California Fire, who will give us some more detailed information on the fire itself. So, Chief.
Again, I'm Chief John Craney. I'm the Division Chief for CAL FIRE, Emergency Command Center. I've been asked to give a quick briefing on what CAL FIRE is currently doing, resources. We have, one thing, we have rescinded the closing the fire season in Northern California for all those units that did close fire season. We are restaffing the engines and the stations, which just means we're going to rehire all the seasonal firefighters, all the engineers that we lay off at the end of the fire season, so we can staff up the resources up there and send them down to Southern California, or be able to fight any new new fires that has occurred, that has done. We're making that announcement has been made today. We have all of our available aircraft, CAL FIRE aircraft, all of our S2s, and all available helicopters in Southern California at this time. We do have a few that are in maintenance, and as soon as they get out of maintenance, the plan is to send them also down. We have activated the DC-10 air tanker that's under contract with CAL FIRE, and it is flying as of today. We're also activated and requested the Martin Mars air tanker, which is a very large air tanker. It should be arriving today. CAL FIRE has staffed up and sent resources to Southern California prior to the Santa Ana conditions in anticipation of what is occurring today, and we are continuing sending resources to Southern California in order to support the firefighting efforts in Southern California. The Santa Ana conditions were expected to continue through tomorrow at approximately 3 o'clock. At that point, they're anticipated to start weakening, but that does not mean that the fire behavior problem is over with. The winds will still continue to blow, the fires are still burning out of control, and it's just going to be a long, drawn-out effort here. Are there any questions?
We'll save some questions and time for the questions at the end. Next, I'd like to introduce Brigadier General Kevin Ellsworth, who's the director of the Joint Staff California National Guard. Give us an update on what the Guard's doing. Yeah.
Sure. Thank you. Good afternoon. The California National Guard has activated a joint task force of over 1,500 California Army and Air National Guard to support this disaster. The crews are currently involved in fire suppression, security, and assistance at the evacuation centers, area security, transportation, both ground and air, medical support, and also communication support. The troops are coming from all over California. Northern California today, this morning, sent out over 400. Over 300 of those were airlifted by C-130 Hercules aircraft out of Modesto, Mather, and Fresno. And the rest are going by ground transport to the impacted area. The modular airborne firefighting systems have also been requested through Title 10 sources. And those will be on station today at Channel Islands and ready for missions tomorrow. The California National Guard and the Nevada National Guard currently have 15 aircraft that are on station, currently dropping water on the impacted areas, impacted fires. We have transportation, airlift, Blackhawks and CH-47s. And we also have coordinated with Arizona, Washington, and Oregon in the event we need backup or additional aircraft. Thank you.
And so right there, you're hearing from Kevin Ellsworth of the California National Guard saying that 1,500 Army and Air Guard soldiers are on or on their way or in Southern California battling that fire down there. As you're seeing in the picture here, the DC-10 that is fighting the fire, as we heard from John Craney, the division chief for CAL FIRE. They call that plane, along with another one called the Martin Mars air tanker, two very large air tankers. That DC-10 capable of hauling 12,000 gallons of retardant and can really lay down a huge line of defense for the ground crews that are simply outnumbered right now. And as you heard John Craney, from the division chief from CAL FIRE, saying they have sent every available resource that they have to Southern California without, of course, jeopardizing other areas or leaving some backup in the north here. But again, everything that's available is going to Southern California. They've rescinded the end of fire season and are rehiring all of their seasonal employees to get them geared up, staffed up, and on their way to Southern California in what he calls, quote, a long, drawn-out effort. We're going to continue to monitor these live pictures. Again, seeing flames on your screen there. Of many thousands of acres burning in Southern California, and we're going to have more on that in just a moment from the KCRA 3 experience.